Today, we're going to do something amazing. We're going to build and launch a brand new application on Heroku in under 20 minutes. What is this mighty magic, you may be wondering? It's called Heroku Vibes, your one-stop shop for building and deploying any application with AI. This will be fun. So let's start with something simple, but hopefully a little bit of fun. Let's assume we want to build a new marketing page for the relaunch of Klustered. We can speak to Heroku Vibes, or at least type, I want to build a new marketing page for the relaunch of Klustered. My interactive, live, debugging, chaotic, Kubernetes challenges. It's launching January 26th, and we are looking for willing victims. So we need a place for engineers to sign up with their email. The aesthetic should be chaos, fun, Kubernetes, blue, mixed with matrix and technology. I don't know, right? This is the beauty of AI. We take our half-assed prompts and ideas and have it turn it into something beautiful, I hope. So let's create with AI. Now, as we know, sometimes AI can be a little bit slow. So what we're going to do is fast forward this. I won't cut or skip. I want you to see everything that's happening as we go. So right away, we can see that Heroku Vibes has created a task list. And this looks pretty cool. Create a project structure for a Node.js application. It's going to use Express. It's going to use Postgres for storing the email signups. Fantastic. Create the HTML landing page with my chaos matrix aesthetic. I even fixed my spelling. Thank you. It's good to style it with Kubernetes Blue, glitch effects and matrix animations. Use some client-side JavaScript. Do the schema. I mean, it's already done the package.json. And of course, the Heroku-specific things, right? I don't need to worry about how to deploy this. It's going to create the proc file, commit it all to Git, and deploy it. Right away, I'm loving this, and I can't wait to see what we get back. Looks like we're getting ready for deployment with a proc file now. So we're getting quite close. Oh, it's attaching Postgres. Very, very close. Okay, I'm done now. It looks like Heroku Vibes is too. Let me just take it in for a moment. It's exactly what I asked for. It's obviously a bit more green than I was expecting, but we did ask for our matrix aesthetic with some clustered Kubernetes blue. But I love the glitchy animations. Nice design. Even a little bit funny. Now, this is pretty cool. My first thought is, what if this could be interactive? What if we need people to unlock the join the chaos, sign up to be a willing victim form by running something here and fixing a pod? So let's do a follow-up and see if we can make this a bit more interesting. Okay, so I've spared you me working on the prompt, but I think I want to go with something like this. Essentially, I want it to be more interactive. I'm going to tone down the matrix and the greens. I want the terminal to be interactive to the point where I want them to be able to run kubectl get pods and hopefully see nothing. Hopefully their intuition is to run kubectl get deployments. Maybe, maybe not, but it should show a zero pod deployment, right? It's been scaled down to zero. It's going to be called sign up form, so it should be quite obvious that we want them to scale that up to at least one running pod, which should pop open the sign up form. So not super simple, right? It's interactive, it's a little bit more complicated, it has to handle certain kube control commands. I don't know what it's going to give us, but again, I'm very curious. So we're going to hit send and see what happens. And I'm looking forward to the task list. Come on, AI, do my bidding. All right. So it's going to understand the current code, tone down the matrix effects exactly. Going to add a terminal. Not sure how it's going to do that, but I'm very curious. And then implement the challenge and turn on the form. All right. I don't think we have to fast forward this one. I think we'll just skip next to when the AI is done and see what we get. So I'll see you in just a moment. All right. So that took a couple of prompts because there were just a few things. So the terminal commands were timing out, I thought. So I thought the WebSocket was broken. I didn't really debug it. I just asked it to fix it. Also, the MOTD, you can see the clustered here, didn't really handle the width of the screen. So I told it to fix it. I then came back and I worked out, it wasn't really timing out, it's just that when I hit enter on the commands, it did nothing. So I went away and fixed that. So, you know, two more prompts to get us to where we are now. But if I run kubectl get deployments, we can see our sign up form. If I run stats, we still got some alignment issues, but we're not going to worry about that. We can see that we've had 3 total commands, 2 for this session. That's because I tested that commands finally worked before hitting record and by running help. We've had 1 kubectl command, which is my get deployments, 2 others, 0 signups, 0 secrets found. Ooh, that's piqued my interest. And my help request that we see here. So let's run help. What's the secret? Or can I work out the secrets? Ooh, I mean, all I did was... Okay, so the secret is the hint. All right, so I was expecting people to type ls to get the get deployments because there is no other hint now that that's what you need to do to qualify. It does have some information on a launch date. I'll take that. Now, I'm curious about the README. Okay, so I think the ls probably shouldn't show the dot file. I think that is supposed to be a secret. LSA does work, so I'll maybe have it fix that, because if you only see the README, the bin, and the server, that's a bit more interesting, although listing bin doesn't actually do anything. Can I cat bin? No. Can I cat server? No. Okay. Let's see help and see what help it's put in. Also, it's saying I can run who am I, I'm a guest, saying I can run sign up, the sign up deployment needs fixed, can I run date, yep, that works okay. Let's do kubectl scale, deployment, sign up form, replica 1, and now we can sign up. All right, that is the form now. And we're done. So it didn't really add any fun Easter eggs that I was hoping, at least not that I found. But maybe that could be a fun experiment. Oh no, it actually does say explore and discover. Like, oh, there's a mission. I think that I'll leave that as an exercise for later. But right now, I'm really happy. I think this is fantastic. I'm looking forward to shipping this and beginning the journey to Klustered 26. Let's have a little recap. So I think Heroku Vibes is pretty cool. I think with agentic programming and developing whatever we're calling it, right, vibe coding, especially with our IDE integrations and our, you know, terminal, cloud codes, etc. They're really good. and that they can build anything that you want in much the way that Heroku Vibes seems to be able to do it. But they stop when you have that working thing or the proof of concept, right? To see it in production is then another mission that you either have to use the agent for or go back to writing Terraform or Pulumi or anything, right? You've got to get it somewhere, provision databases. Why I think Heroku Vibes is so compelling to me is I didn't have to provision my own Redis or my own Postgres or even write my own Docker file. It literally deployed everything for me. And what I was testing against was the production version, or at least the staging version, and then we could promote it, right? That Git repository is now there for me to pull and do whatever I want with, put it into my own Git repository and add Heroku as a new remote, and then continue using local tools. But the fact that I can just have Heroku Vibes do this for me is super interesting. I really enjoyed playing with that. This was a simple application. I think for the next video, what we'll do is try and build something that is a lot more components and a lot more production and is going to lean in to all of the offerings of Heroku. So stay tuned. We'll be back very, very soon. Until next time, have a great day.